My name is Katya Gutierrez, and I was a Jehovah's Witness for 23 years. Christian and I escaped the Watchtower organization 4 years ago. The reason that we want to make this documentary is to bring awareness to the fact that the Jehovah's Witness organization destroys families' lives. We know of hundreds of thousands of other people just like us who've also had their lives destroyed and their families taken from them. These are their stories. After a brief trip to London, where I interviewed former Jehovah's Witnesses on shunning and the sexual abuse cover-ups within the Watchtower organization, I just knew I had to keep investigating this issue. But before returning to Canada, I decided to head over to my birth country, Denmark, where I learned of a woman who lost contact with all her children. This is her story.
My name is Maria. I have been Jehovah's Witnesses for 43 years and also been pioneer for 2 years of my life.
I'm from Copenhagen.
You've lived in Denmark your whole
life? Yeah, I have.
Yeah.
I am born in two. The Jehovah's Witnesses. My parents was being a witness when they were youth.
When they were kids?
Yeah.
Okay. So you are a second generation?
Yeah. Well, I always have felt a little bit, you know, different others. And we don't celebrate birthdays or Christmas and so. And I felt it was a little bit weird that I don't was a part of that. And my parents was very much theocratic, you know, high level inside the organization. So there was pioneers, and my dad was talking with the assemblies, and so was elder in the meeting hall. I think I was raised to be an elite JV. That caused a lot of stress. Yes, it does. Mm-hmm. But I was going to be a pioneer. I was, you know, when you're raised in a Jehovah's Witnesses, you follow your family, because the family is very important. And then I was going to be a pioneer too, because my parents was thinking that, no, you don't have an education, because Jehovah is going to be here with his new kingdom, and you don't have to. We have to pioneer, preaching for people.
So you didn't go to college or?
No, I went out for the school.
Yeah. So did you have children? Were you married in the organization?
Yeah, I was married with a pioneer too, Michael, when I was 18 years, and we got Marco when I was 21. And in the start, Michael and I was pioneering. And in that time, we start to see how the organization, how the elders was manipulating with many of us. Yeah, it was when we have actually a party in one of the congregations in Copenhagen, and one of the elders was drinking so much. So he was dancing on the table, and he was lost his pants. And we were totally shocked, my husband and I, because we were very much, you know, elite Jehovah's Witnesses. So that was very strange for us to cover. So then we were talking to the elder, and then they said, oh no, we're just shutting it down. But I have kids. Yes, I have 3 kids. I have Marco on 24 and Milo on 16 and Mila on 14.
I mean, obviously you were raised a Jehovah's Witness and you believed it your whole life.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What made you one day start to doubt it or not believe in it?
I think it was because of... I was always thinking that when we got the Watchtower, you know, on the Sunday meeting, I was beginning to wondering why when you have a, you know, a paragraph, what do you call it?
Mm-hmm, like English,
in the article, then there was questions. You should take the answer from what there stood. You can't think self. You should read up where they stand. You can use your own words, but the particle was the basic things. It's not from yourself, it's from the organization. They give you the answer and they take some quotes out of the Bible, and then they said, okay, that's why we do so. And I was beginning to thinking that's not okay. It's brainwash. Mm. And I remember I was saying that to my husband, and we were also experienced a very many things in our congregation where we moved to, where actually my brother-in-law was also lying, also cheating with his company and so. And I was so, I just couldn't be there anymore. I don't think there was a difference about be in and out. I was realizing that when I start to work, and I was meeting these worthy people who was evil, and I have learned that all my life. But suddenly I found out they are the most beautiful people. That was a big part of going out. Yeah. But it takes me 10 years. I was being calling into a meeting with 3 elders and with the Bible, and don't have any company with worldly people and so. And I just think when I go out there, okay, I try, but I know inside me I was changing. And then I stopped coming to the meeting, not on one time, but slowly. Mm-hmm. So at the last time, I was saying to my husband, I can't stand in for this organization more. There's so much lie, and there's so much crap, and I don't believe in it anymore. Mm-hmm. And then I said to him, do you love me, or do you love Jehovah more? And then he looked ice cold on me, and then he said, you know, I love Jehovah more.
Wow.
And then I said, okay, then I want a divorce. We were soulmates in 25 years, so we have a very good time together. Also our up and downs, but we have a good marriage. But he don't want me in his life when I'm not a Jehovah more. So his feelings is more for Jehovah and for me. Mm-hmm. And that's whole my family is mm-hmm. on the same opinion. So
are you disfellowshipped? Are you still a Jehovah? Like, what is the relationship you have with
We do that I was, what do you call it, spiritual weak.
You're labeled spiritually weak?
Yeah, in a year or two. And then... then when I have that discussion or talk with my husband, I said, okay, I'm going to move. Then I got my own house, and we were separate. And in the start, I got the kids 7 days a week. But I can feel every time they came to me, they was
uncomfortable
with because they have been talking to my parents, who are still Jehovah's Witness, my sister, my brother-in-law, and my nieces, and they were all say, "Mama is crazy. Mama is, you have to shun her. She's bad. She's wealthy, and she's going to die in Armageddon. So you don't have to take moments with her."
Your relationship with your children when you were a Jehovah's Witness, did you have a good relationship with your children?
Yeah, very much.
So do you feel like your relationship with them now has changed because of the organization?
Yeah, they have asked them to shun me.
The organization?
Not in, you know, directly, but indirectly. I have given birth to 3 kids who is not able to see me. Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, that's hard. That's very hard. It's totally heartbreaking, totally. I can't describe the feeling. It is it is a very hard time in my life. And, but I hang on to a wish I hope will go through, that they will see that we are not so dangerous out here. We are normally people, and they are going right now being brainwashed by an organization who is human created. And I don't hope they should spend so many years as I was. Yeah, I want them to know that I will always love them. And I'm hoping with all my heart that they will come.
So your arms are open to them anytime, right?
Anytime. And I have try to text them or call them every week in a long, long, long time. But they don't answer me. I am totally shut. I've never been close to my sister, but this one, when she spoke so much against me, and in front of my children, that says more about her than about me, because I have all the time sent positive texts. I have just said my opinion about the organization, yes, but I have never speaking evil to her or to them. Mm-hmm. I have always said, okay, I have love to you, and when you're ready, I'm ready. All that outside, you know, it's disgusting. Mm-hmm. Always the new car, always the cleanest car, always the high heels, always the newest clothes. It is glamour who is, it's fail.
Maria, how long has it been since you've seen your children?
It's 1.5 year ago for the 2 youngest, and the biggest one, 3 years. All children should have the opportunity to decide by themselves what they want. Mm-hmm. And you can't decide what you want. You fought it that, okay, we have a free will, but it's not that. Mm-hmm. Because when you're trying to get out, they shun you.
Is there anything you would want the public to know about this organization?
Yes, stay away from them. Don't let them in your life. Your life is going to be ruined. Break up families. But I think they have a big responsibility over so many people. And that all the cheat, all the pedophilic cages we are hearing about, all the things that they just agree with and accept, I disgust them. I really hate them. And they have all these messages who then are brainwashing you to do what they want. the loss of three kids is heartbreaking. It is fantastic, and I really hope so many people inside will see that it is a very, very nice world. Yes, we have evil here too, but there is so many nice people. You can do so much.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm lucky to be here with my boyfriend and explore a new world that has been closer to me.
Yeah, freedom, right?
Freedom. Yeah.
What is one thing that you've been able to do since not being a Jehovah's Witness that just makes you happy?
Well, I think just that I can spoke with everyone I want. I love to celebrate Christmas and birthdays and Halloween and St. Hans we have here in Denmark.
Yeah.
So nice. I love it. I'm not going back.
Even though you've lost a lot being in the organization, and these things will always hurt you, right? I mean, you can't stop being hurt.
A black part of my life.
Yes, you will always suffer because of it. Why won't you go back despite those things that hurt you?
Because I know that my freedom is the biggest thing in my life. I don't want to go in prison again. And it is so nice that we worldwide have all these friends on Facebook that we can join the groups, and I've learned you to know and many people who is so nice. Something I want to say that when you are inside, you always, they always said to you that in this world there's no friends who is real. Inside the family is real for you and all that stuff. But the reality is that I found out that we have so many friends worldwide. I can come and visit you in Canada, you visit me
visit here.
Visit
me here in Denmark.
And Australia and USA. All these places. Yeah. Unconditional love.
Mm-hmm. I really do hope for you that your children will be free one day
that will be the best.
Because
part
you
of my
are
life.
Obviously a very loving mother. Mm. So they deserve you.